Welcome and good day. This is our first formal topic discussion. So we'll go to the same textbook that we talked about previously. So this is the 10th edition of the Financial Accounting by Wagan, Kemel, and Queso. So let us proceed. So this is chapter 1. So, titled Accounting in Action. So what are the actions that we are going to do in an accounting process? Okay, so we have to tell you that we could expect everybody to learn the following. At the end of this chapter, you will be able to identify the activities and users associated with accounting. Who are those people? Explain the building blocks of accounting, ethics, principles, and assumptions. State the accounting equation and define its components. Analyze the effects of business transactions on accounting equation. So we'll also have computation here, very basic, not the same on your engineering computation. However, still we have calculation and equation at that. Define those components. You could also expect that we will be able to analyze the effects of business transactions on the accounting equation. And lastly, we could expect ourselves to be able to describe the four financial statements and how they are prepared. Okay? For our lesson one, identifying the activities and users associated with accounting. So in this lesson, we will define what is the basic activities that involves accounting. If we say accounting, it means identifying, recording, and communicating the economic events of an organization to interested users. Okay? So, interested users. Not to everyone. Economic events. So economic events meaning those events that have something to do with finances. Money, not just in terms of cash, but and other forms of value. Okay? So for example, this mouse is not a cash, but it has a value. It has a value because it has something, you need something to buy a similar one. For example, if you destroy this one, you will be penalized and to give the replacement. The replacement will cost you something. Okay? So, same as this. So, that is how we actually see the value on the non-cash parts of the organization. So, repeat, identifying, recording, and communicating. So, these three activities of identification, recording, and communication have the accounting on its cycle, actually. So after communicating, another cycle. So if we have a cycle, there must be some period. So for example, 1 month or 2 months or 3 months or 1 quarter or semi-annually or annually. So we can record and communicate those outputs in a certain period. Then after that, another cycle. Okay? Okay, so What are we going to expect for identification? Selecting economic events. So these economic events are what we call transactions. What are the transactions that we are going to be involved in this process? So not all the activities of the company must be recorded or must be communicated in such a very formal accounting process. So only the selected events, which are what we call transactions. So transaction meaning there is a trade of services or product, goods, in exchange of money or in kind. Okay? So, or equivalent amount in value, in worth. Okay? So, that is what we mean by transaction. There's an exchange. Okay? And in recording, we are now going to cleanly classify and summarize and make it in a form that is easier to understand. Because we are going to communicate these records by presenting reports, what we call accounting reports. And later on, those who will receive our reports will be able to what? Utilize these reports in order to analyze and interpret so that they can make what? Informed decisions. Okay? Who uses the accounting data? So these are the users. So finance group, marketing group, management group, and HR or human resources. Okay? So there are several users, as you can see, and each and every users have different perspective and importance on this report. So communicating this single report to them will enable them to get their data. Those data that are only important to their group. For example, in the finance group, the most important to them maybe is our organization's cash sufficient to be able to distribute dividends to stockholders. Okay? And for the marketing group, it could be important for them to determine what price should the organization charge for something that the organization could offer, whether it is a product, goods, or services. And for the management, it could be important for them which organization's product is the most profitable. Product meaning goods and services. Okay? Which services could they offer which is most profitable? Maybe the least profitable one, the following year, they will what? Cut it off. And those top three profitable ones are what? They are going to increase the concentration of energy, efforts, and time on those product. And for human resources, it could be important for them to know if the organization could afford to give its employees increase in what salaries and wages. Okay, so different organization, internal organization or external people could utilize. So in this one, internal users. We can also be of use to external users. So for example, we have investors. These are not part of the internal companies, but they are interested in the growth of the company because they invest, they want to get an income. Okay? So creditors, they are also very much interested because they are thinking, how could we be able to pay up our debts? Okay? The profitable our company will be the easier their credit would be able to pay up. No? So investors could also be interested in comparing their investment to other investment. So they may be able to determine and decide if their investment in the company is not really much working, they may transfer their investment to other companies. Okay? So they would decide on that. Okay? So that's why it's also better for the company to have a good standing so that the investors will stay. If the investor will run away, what will happen to the company? The cash flow of the company will be severely hit and would not be able to run the operations smoothly. Okay? Basic concepts. So we can take this as an exercise. So let us ask you a question. After very simple explanations a while ago, could you indicate whether the following statements are true or false? Number one, the three steps in accounting process are identification, recording, and communication. Okay? So I'll give you 5 seconds, or you can pause the video and play it again after you able to answer the question. Number two, bookkeeping encompasses all steps in accounting process. So bookkeeping is the keeping of the records. That is what we mean by bookkeeping. So we keep the records. If we say books in, as in accounting books, accounting books is the record books. It is being kept in the company. Okay? So it has a list of all the important transactions that have something to do with economic aspects of the company. So that is bookkeeping. We are keeping the records. Okay? So, can you answer that question? Is bookkeeping encompasses all steps in accounting process? Okay. Number three, accountants prepare but do not interpret financial reports. Okay. So, what do we mean by accountants? Accountants are those people that actually do the bookkeeping. They actually do the recording and keeping the records in shape and making the records properly classified and listed and in safe condition and continuous. So without gap, for example, 1 year, all the months are supposed to be there. There is no gap of 1 month or gap of 2 months because what? The accountant took vacation leave. So a replacement of the accountant must be hired by the company, okay? So that there is no gap. So continuous recording of accounts. So book of accounts, the record books is the book of accounts, okay? So those persons that are doing those job is what we call accountants. And there are accountants and there are what we call certified public accountants. The difference is certified public accountants or CPA are those accountants that are licensed by the government to do its work. And they are licensed to do all the activities without limitation of an accountant, like auditing, taxation, and this bookkeeping and recording. So those are some of the accounting activities that can be done by a certified public accountant. So they can sign the document that could make the document legal in the eyes of the law. For example, taxation. If the tax declaration is signed by the CPA, it is seen as a legal document. Okay? So it is the ordinary accountant cannot sign those types of documents. So that is the difference. So accountants prepare but do not interpret financial report. Is this true or false? Number four, the two most common types of external users are investors and company officers. Hey, is this true or false? The two most common types. Okay. And number five, managerial accounting activities focus on reports for internal users. Okay. This is not explained, but you can backtrack the explanation and connect the explanation, and you can solve, you can determine if this statement is true or false. I repeat, is managerial accounting activities focus on reports for internal users? Okay, so let's continue. So number one, we know that because the three steps are identification, recording, and communication. That is true. Okay? And number two, bookkeeping encompasses all steps in the accounting process. This is false. Okay? Bookkeeping is the initial stage. For example, communicating, that is not bookkeeping. Okay? So the process revolves from identification, recording, and communication. And cycle. Okay? And bookkeeping do not encompass all of those. Number three, accountants prepare but do not interpret financial reports. This is false. Sometimes they need to interpret it so that they actually need to interpret this. CPA is required to interpret it because the users will just analyze. The users will analyze. So Usually there are some sentences that constitutes the interpretation of the accountants, no? Okay. And number four, the two most common types of external users are investors and company officers. So there are several users, as we have discussed. There are several internal users and several external users. It's not only two, no? So, managerial accounting activities focus on internal users, so this is true. So, and financial accounting activities are focused on external users. Focus, but it can also be used by internal, but the focus is external users. So, these are the ideas, principles for lesson one. And thank you very much. And we'll see you next meeting.